announcements. I am a feminist and I do not hate men or women who are not feminists. I am a feminist and I laugh. That means there's no danger for anybody in the next 18 minutes. Sit back and relax. Friends, I'm really glad that I'm giving this talk in the month of March, because it is in this month that we women and men who love equality celebrate our global, secular and biggest festival called the International Women's Day, 8th March. On this day, we celebrate womanhood. On this day, we think of all our foremothers and forefathers who worked hard for our rights so that today I can stand here and give a TED talk. A young woman can dream of playing football. Other young women in the crowd can come from Kashmir and go to universities here. We didn't get this as charity from anywhere. We got it because people worked for it. I don't know if how many of you know that in Harvard University, after men got admission, it took 237 years for the first woman to be allowed into Harvard. Cambridge and Oxford took longer, 260 years. So I salute all my foremothers and forefathers on whose shoulders I stand here, friends. I do know that feminism is very badnaam hai, that many people neither like the word nor what it stands for. And still, if somebody asks me, I'm a feminist. Why? So that I can get an opportunity to explain to you what my feminism is. When I say my feminism, it's clear that there is no one feminism. There is a plurality of feminisms and feminists. My feminism is the thing which lit my bulb. Agar meri batti thodi bahut jali hui hai, wo feminism ke karan jali hui hai. My feminism is like a torch, is like a deepak, a bulb, trying to fight the darkness of patriarchy, the injustice, unfairness, and violence of patriarchy. My feminism has been my life, my creativity, my friends all over the world. Friends, my feminism is against sexism, discrimination based on sex. It is against all kinds of discrimination. It's against patriarchy. Patriarchy is a social system in which, by definition, men are considered to be superior, and in which men have more control over resources, decision making, and ideology. And of course, half of humanity should not like patriarchy. So we are against patriarchy, not against men. And men, many men accept patriarchy, many women accept patriarchy. And they don't just accept patriarchy, they teach patriarchy to their children and they perpetuate it. So we are not against normal human beings who maybe don't understand what patriarchy is. Friends, my feminism is not Western. My feminism is local, it's organic. That is why in South Asia, what are the issues we have taken up? Sati, dowry. In Pakistan, we took up the issue of Hudud ordinance. We have taken up the issue of child marriage, sex selective abortions, because of which in India, 35 million girls and women have been killed. 35 million. So my feminism is local, but my feminism is also global, because patriarchy is global. Violence is global. Discrimination is global. My feminism, friends, is like water. Water takes the shape of the container in which it is put. And my feminism takes the shape according to the patriarchy which exists in our society. A feminist said, feminism is the radical notion that women are human. Patriarchy doesn't consider women to be human. Another woman, who didn't even call herself a feminist, said, every time I refuse to be a doormat, they call me a feminist. Sometimes other people call you a feminist before you call yourself a feminist. So feminism is only about equality. It is about humanity of women and men. It is about our rights as half of humanity. And nothing else. It is not about dominating men. Our feminism, friends, is not saying I want to be the same as men. I can't be the same as men. Moreover, are all men the same? All the men sitting here, are you all the same? Do you think the same? Do you like the same things? No. Are all women sitting here the same? No. So we don't want to be the same. We just want to be equal. And that's what the Indian Constitution says, that men and women are equal. Just as these five fingers are not the same, but they are equal. They have their roles, and if this one bleeds, I hurt. And the beauty of this finger is because it is small. If it had become too tall, it would have to be cut. So we are not looking for sameness, we are looking only and only for equality. For some feminists, patriarchy is very closely linked to class, to caste, to racism, to heteronormativity. So we believe we can't fight inequality between men and women alone. We also fight inequality between castes, classes, religions, ethnicity, races, etc. These days we are using a big long word. You might as well hear it. It's called intersectionality. A Dalit woman is raped much more than an educated woman like me, because she's a woman and a Dalit and poor. So the three systems are oppressing her. And we accept that and we understand her problems. Friends, let me share with you my feminist journey. Till I was 26 years old, I'd never heard this word. Neither feminism nor Narivad. But the age of 4 or 5, I think I had feminist urges. Like my 3 brothers and the boys in the village in Rajasthan where I grew up, I wanted to play outside. I didn't know how to play football then, or hadn't heard women playing football, but I could bloody well play gilli danda. I wanted to learn how to whistle, and not just that. I wanted to climb the trees. I wanted to go to school. As simple as that was my feminism. But between the ages of 3 and 8, I was sexually abused by 14 different men in those 6 years, 4 years. They were all known to the family, relatives, friends of brother or father, one bloody tailor, teachers. After I was 8 or 9, I knew how to avoid those kinds of men and how to avoid sexual abuse. I don't know how many women can say they have never been sexually abused, or at least have had the fear of being sexually abused. So friends, you don't have to know the word feminist or read books on feminism to become a feminist. I don't think 500 years ago, Mirabai in Rajasthan, or Rabia of Basra, or Lal Ded of Kashmir, or Savitribai Phule of Maharashtra, whether they had read feminist books. Books don't teach you feminism. Injustice does. Patriarchy does. Violence does. Lack of freedom does. That's what makes us feminists. Now you can ask, okay, as a feminist, what did you do? Well, the first thing I tried to do, as I said, I grew up in villages. My father was a medical doctor in Rajasthan. 6 children. First thing I did was to study. Went to government schools, went to a government college in Rajasthan, did my MA, and then worked very hard and got a fellowship to go to Germany. There, I got a job in German government, a permanent, very well-paid job. I resigned after 11 months, and I came back to Udaipur, Rajasthan, to join an NGO at the royal salary of 250 rupees. We worked with Adivasis and with Dalits, men, women and children. After 4 years there, I was offered a job by the UN in Bangkok at a massive salary. 40 times the salary which I was getting in Seva Mandir. With that money, me, a feminist, helped my younger siblings, helped them get educated, helped them get jobs, helped my parents financially, emotionally, and in every other way. Towards the end of my mother's life, we had lost our father already, she came to live with me. I think she didn't get along with her daughters-in-law. She came to live with me in my marital home. And she died in my home. Together, my brothers and me carried her arthi, her bier. Together, we performed the last rites. The Panditji did try to tell me that Indian women don't do that. I said, yes, Panditji, I know, but if you want your 500 rupees, you better allow me. and he loved his 500 rupees more than his principles. My brothers and I also examined certain cultural and religious festivals which made my brothers superior, like Raksha Bandhan, like Bhaiya Dooj. We wondered, can a Bhaiya Dooj be done without a behen? No. Then why don't we call it behen Bhai Dooj? So we put the tikka on each other's things, and I promised them I'll help them in every possible way, and they promised me that they will help me in every possible way. Friends, cultures don't make human beings. Human beings make cultures, and that's what we need to understand here today. And secondly, culture is not a dead thing. Culture changes with time, and it should change with time, and today our culture and our religious practices should change according to the Indian constitution, which says all human beings in India are equal, whatever their sex, their religion, their caste. So culture has to adjust to that, rather than that to adjust to our culture. I'm a feminist, but I did get married, and to a man. Now that man did not like to work in a job, because he found most organizations undemocratic, rigid. He wanted to have the same freedom which many educated women with MA and PhD degrees have, who decide to become homemakers. So he decided to be a homemaker. Why? Because he had a feminist wife who was willing to work, and who was not ashamed that her partner did not earn any money. Our marriage was not ownership by him of me. Our marriage was a partnership. So neither he changed his name, his surname, nor I changed my surname. We got married in Bangkok, we went to the Indian embassy with four friends, signed, came back. No kanyadan. Do you realize that the custom of kanyadan is against the Indian constitution? No father even has the right to give a kanya in dan. She's not a thing. She's not an object. No kanyadan, no touching of the feet of my lord and master. No use of words pati parmeshwar, shohar, majazi khuda, swami, even husband. Look up a good dictionary tonight and see, the word husband does not connote equality. Same word as animal husbandry. Same word. So husbands are those who tame women, who domesticate women. Now none of us had to domesticate anybody. We had two children. I had to give birth and breastfeed. You know why? Because like all men, my poor husband had a body without a uterus and without breasts. So I was quite happy to do this most creative work of my life. But my partner did everything else for which neither breasts nor uterus is required. Like running a home, you don't need a uterus, you don't need breasts. Like tying nappies, like cleaning children, bathing them, he did everything. Now what did this partnership do? It freed me, gave me the freedom to do what I wanted. Gave him the freedom to do what he wanted. He didn't want to do a job. He wanted to pursue his interest in jazz, in social activism, in doing public litigation to help some causes. both could lead human lives and not manufactured, stereotyped, gendered lives. You are a man, you will do this, and you are a woman, you will do this. We were both free. And I believe feminism frees not just women. If women are free, only then will our brothers and fathers be free. My brothers and father did not have to chaperone me wherever I was going. In our families, a six-year-old boy is told, "Ja, 20 saal ki didi hai, uske saath chala ja bazaar." Wo bibi PhD kar rahi didi, wo 6 saal ka ladka, chowkidar, or maybe jasus, who knows? My parents and my brothers did not have to go look for a husband for me, prepare a dowry for me. They were free because I was free. I could stand on my own legs. They supported it. Now let's do one thing, friends. Close your eyes and think of a feminist. Your normal thought about feminists. I suppose in many minds, a middle class, educated, jeans clad, short haired, maybe smoking woman. Yes, such feminists do exist. But what about the vegetable seller in my colony who comes at 8 o'clock in the morning and says, "Alu lelo, pyaaz lelo, tomato lelo," every morning at 8 o'clock? That means she must have got up at 5 o'clock to go to the mandi and to get her vegetable. Tall, handsome, strong woman, and I found out she's a single woman, looking after 3 children because the husband is absconding, maybe gone for another woman. What about this woman I met 3 days ago? Her name is Annu Kumari from Ajmer district. She was married off at the age of 3. And as the custom there is, when they become 13, 14, 15, they send them to their husband's family. By that time, this woman had started going to school. And she said, "I am not going. I do not recognize that marriage at 3. But the Jati Panchayat said, 'We will fine you, we'll do this, we'll do that.'" She fought the Jati Panchayat. And she escaped that marriage. A village woman. A feminist or not? Young Malale from Pakistan, the youngest Nobel Peace Laureate, a feminist? Her father, is he a feminist or not? Mr. Mahendra Singh Phogat, who trained his daughters as wrestlers, and his wife, are they feminists or not? The millions of girls in Bihar, breaking all the shackles of patriarchy, cycling their way to school with laptops in their bags. Feminists or not? Almost 1 million women who got elected to panchayats and municipalities in the last 25 years. And many of them, at least 50% of them, doing brilliant work. Feminists or not? So this notion, friends, that feminists are urban, educated, middle-class women is wrong. In India, the feminist movement, the women's movement is so much stronger in the villages. You just have to see to believe. You are a feminist, you cannot enjoy most Bollywood and Hollywood films, because leaving aside 1%, 99% of them are making men Dabang, Battamiz, Dawn, Superman, Spider-Man, Salman, सबको बना रहे. And what are they making us? मुन्नी बदनाम हुई. They are singing songs and now this time try not to laugh. Because as long as we laugh, it will continue. A song which says, लौंडिया पटाएंगे मिस्ड कॉल से. यानी आपको दोस्ती करनी नहीं आती, आप उस औरत को पटा रहे हो. अब पूरे हिंदुस्तान की लड़कियां जो हैं लौंडिया बन गई आपके लिए. मैं तंदूरी मुर्गी हूं, मुझे विस्की से गटका ले. जस्ट लुक एट द इमेजरी इन दिस. वुमेन आर तंदूरी मुर्गीज, मैन विल गल्प देम डाउन विद विस्की. दिस फिल्म गॉट बिजनेस ऑफ ओवर 100 crores. सो हुम डू आई ब्लेम? The people like you and me who gave it 100 crore business, or the producers? So friends, this is what we need to look at. Feminism makes us angry because there's so much to get angry about. But have you heard feminists burning buses? We've never burnt buses. We've never picked up a gun and killed people like in the US they do every 10 days or 50 days, all men. My last few words are, feminism is for gender equality. All research in the world tells you that you need men and women to be equal for societies to go ahead, for families to be happy, for children to be happy. All research says that gender equality is not a zero-sum game, women will benefit, men will lose. No. It is win-win for both. Feminism only improves our countries and our homes, friends. And since men and women have to live together, only if women are free will men be free. And my biggest slogan in life is not love of power, but power of love. Our message is power of love. So, why be afraid of feminism? Embrace it, become a feminist, make this world a better world. Thank you very much.